Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I am Nitin Eusebius, a Senior Solution Architect with AWS. Today, I will be talking about basics of AWS IoT Core data, VPC endpoints, and connectivity pattern. I collaborate with many customers who want to connect their physical devices on the field to AWS IoT Core data privately, such as private APNs or VPNs. For example, customers collecting data from machines in a connected factory may not want to expose their local factory network to the internet for security or safety reasons. So let's get started to see some of the reference pattern of using private connectivity to AWS IoT Core data using VPC endpoints. You will start with your AWS IoT Core data, which is integrated with AWS PrivateLink, enabling you to create private IoT Core data endpoints in your virtual private cloud or VPC, which is a virtual network dedicated to your AWS account, using Interface VPC endpoints powered by AWS PrivateLink. AWS PrivateLink is an AWS technology that enables private communication between your VPC and AWS services, such as AWS IoT Core, by using private IP addresses that are not reachable from the public internet and do not require an internet gateway or NAT devices to access. For each subnet that you specify from your VPC, it creates an Endpoint Network Interface, or ENI, in the subnet and assign it a private IP address from the subnet address range. Then, you will extend the private connectivity all the way to your on-premises network using VPN or Direct Connect Private WIF. AWS Direct Connect is a network service that provides an alternative to using the internet and enables customer to have low latency, secure, and private connection to AWS. Now that we have a reference pattern on how to do a private connectivity to AWS IoT Core data, let's go a little bit deeper to see how to do hybrid DNS resolution with Amazon Route 53 resolver endpoints. So how does it actually work? Let's take an end-to-end look. Amazon Route 53 resolver endpoints enables you to do hybrid DNS resolution to and from your on-premises network. In this reference architecture, we have selected one subnet per availability zone to achieve high availability when creating VPC endpoint for AWS IoT Core data. For example, a device located in the corporate data center needs to resolve an AWS IoT data endpoint domain name. The AWS IoT device data endpoint supports a publish-subscribe protocol that is designed for the communication needs of an IoT device. It sends the query to its pre-configured DNS resolver. The DNS resolver in the corporate data center has a conditional forwarder rule that points any DNS query for AWS IoT data endpoint DNS domains to the Amazon Route 53 resolver inbound endpoints. The forwarded query arrives at Amazon Route 53 resolver inbound endpoints to either AWS Direct Connect or an AWS site-to-site VPN, as noted before. All inbound DNS queries will flow through this VPC on the way to resolver. To improve reliability, resolver requires that you specify two IP addresses for DNS queries. We recommend that you specify IP addresses in two different availability zones. The Amazon Route 53 resolver inbound endpoint sends the query to VPC plus 2 resolver within the VPC. Because DNS VPC is associated with Amazon Route 53 private hosted zone of AWS IoT data endpoint, the default DNS server will be able to resolve this domain to the VPC endpoint. For security, set VPC interface endpoint with security groups and network ACLs on endpoint elastic network interface, and controlling access to AWS IoT Core data over VPC endpoint by using VPC condition context keys. In this episode, we explored how to use AWS IoT Core data VPC endpoints with some reference end-to-end architecture. We also saw best practices of doing hybrid DNS resolution using Amazon Route 53 resolver endpoints and security best practices. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.